Hello everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're diving into one of the most flexible layout features Droip has to offer, the grid. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be able to build and structure complex layouts with ease using Droip's grid system. So let's jump right into it. We'll be building a layout that's simple in logic but slightly tactical in placement, the one you see on screen. At first, you will see how you can manually position your grid items. And secondly, you will experience how you can design the exact same thing with the concept of area. Now, don't get overwhelmed. Just because we have a sketched structure, things will be so easier, and you will find that in a few seconds. Now, before we start placing elements, remember two golden rules while working with grids. First, sketch or visualize the structure you want, and then go ahead and map your items into that structure. So, heading into our editor now. And as you can see, we've already set up our nav bar from the previous video. And to start building the structure, our grid layout, we'll go to the Insert panel, then the Elements panel. After that, we'll first take a section, inside that drop a container, and finally add a grid. You'll notice there are already some ready-made layout presets in this panel. Now, we will give our grid a structure of 6 columns and 4 rows, just like the blueprint on the screen. Well, you can do this from the inline grid options here. Or you can also go to the Structure panel and set the rows and columns with the Tracks tab, or by switching to Grid Controller mode, and then type your preferred row and column count. Whichever of the options works for you. Now that our base is ready, we'll add 4 divs, and these will serve as placeholders for our 4 content blocks. Once those are added, our structuring phase is done, and it's time to map them. So, when we select a div, by default, the divs will fall into place from left to right because of the auto-placement settings of the grid items. But we want a more specific arrangement. Let's switch to Manual Placement in the Grid Items tab. Using our visual blueprint as a reference, you can now understand why there are so many numbers just to map them. It gives us a clear image that our first content box will start from column 3 and end at the beginning of column 5. This is how the CSS column start column end work, and the same goes for the rows. Now, let's just place our contents just as we have mapped here. The first item will span from column 3 to 5 and row 1 to 3. The second one is placed from column 3 to 5 and row 3 to 5. The third one ranges from column 1 to 3 and row 2 to 4. And the fourth one spans from column 5 to 7 and row 2 to 4. Let's apply a white background to each of the divs for better visibility. Now, let's populate the divs with our actual content. Head to the Symbols panel and drag the cards one by one into each div. And just like that, it's taking the exact placement of the grids that we have set. Also, don't forget to add some spacing between items. Select the grid and adjust the gaps evenly for cleaner breathing room. And it took us just a few minutes, maybe 3 to 4 minutes. Next, let's try another method, that is area mapping. We have our 4x6 grid ready, and the 4 divs for 4 content blocks are also ready. Now let's go back to grid controller mode, and here click the plus icon to create new areas, and simply drag to define your zones. We'll create 4 of them, just like before. The first one is like that, the second area would be like this, and the third one from the left side, and the fourth one is at the right side. Our structure is ready to roll. Time for mapping the contents. Now, select each div and assign it to the appropriate area using the Grid Items tab. There goes Area 1, then Area 2 at the bottom, Area 3 is at the left, and Area 4 at the right. Once done, we go to the Symbols tab and drag our cards to each area, and it takes just a few drags to place the items in the areas. Oh, and again, set your spacing from the grid settings. That's it. With Droip grids, it's so easy to map items in different positions. You can simply drag a tick and choose your coordinates, and you can design asymmetric contents to give that modern feels. And that's a wrap for today. Let's quickly recap. We created a grid with a 4x6 structure and added 4 divs, as we have 4 content blocks. Then we mapped them manually using row and column positions from the Grid Items tab. And lastly, we used area-based placement for the same result to explore a simpler approach. Both methods are super effective, and now it's your turn to try it out. Let us know in the comments how long it took you to build this layout in Droip. And as always, don't forget to stay tuned, because in the next one, we will show how to manage and fetch contents through the Droip Content Manager. And also, we will share some tricks with Flexboxes as well. See you next time!